Cause I don't wanna fall in love. Hi guys, it's Mai. Today I'm gonna be showing you guys two DIY ideas for the 4th of July. And I know it's kinda soon, but anyway, you can use this for any other like patriotic holiday. So first it's this DIY headband, which is like red, white, and blue floral crown. And I made a previous floral crown video, which is just a plain one, and it's really similar to it. So I'll put the link down for that one below. And this one has just all different kinds of flowers. And then the back has two red, white, and blue beads, and I think it's really cute.
It looks like that.
And yeah, and also I'm gonna be teaching you guys how to make this shirt. It's like a graphic tee. And yeah, this is so easy to do. It's not hard at all, and it's so easy to make like a perfect heart and stuff like that. So yeah, this is perfect for 4th of July, and I know I'll definitely be wearing this shirt out to wherever I go. So I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. And yeah, so just keep watching to learn how to make these two DIYs. Okay, so the first thing you need is some leather string, some fake flowers, and a hot glue gun. So the first thing I'm going to do is just cut a piece off that is the shape of my head, and I'm also going to put it flat in half so that way I know where the middle is. And then I'm going to mark both sides when I put it around my head and see where the knot would be when I tie it. So I'm just going to mark them with like a white or like a light colored pencil so that way it shows up on the string. Next, I'm going to take my fake flowers and then pop all the flowers off the actual stems, and you could just see that they come off really easily. And then I'm going to take a scissor and kind of cut off that thing that sticks off at the end, so that way when you wear your headband, it doesn't poke you in the head. Now I'm just going to go ahead and rearrange them in the way that I want them to be on my headband. So I just put them in any random order, and yeah. So then after this, you're going to just take, I had extra small flowers, so I wanted to fill the spaces up in between. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just taking off the flowers and kind of, I'm just going to put them in between the big flowers that I glue on. I also took some of the extra small flowers and kind of put them underneath the glue when I was gluing it on, so that way it wouldn't stick to anything else and make it also smoother. So after you've done that, your headband is complete, and now you have a really easy headband. And I also just added some beads at the end, and that's optional. But yeah, I think it looks really cute and perfect for the 4th of July. So now I'll show you guys the next DIY. The next DIY requires a little bit more materials than you usually would have at home, so I'll list everything down in the bottom bar below. So the first thing I'm going to do is take my little printout of the heart, and I'm going to just basically copy it, or you could trace it, and then I'm going to draw the lines and the stars, and then I'm shading it in, and now taking my X-Acto knife, I'm going to be cutting out all the shaded parts, so this is where I'm going to be using the paint. Next, I'm going to cut out where the stars would be, so I'm kind of going to go very thin around the edge and just pop that whole thing out, and don't worry about the stars because I'll be doing something next. So it should look like this right now. And then I'm going to be taking a piece of like cardboard and putting it underneath the t-shirt so that way the paint won't stick to the other side. And I'm spraying my tacky spray onto the back of the design, and this will make a temporary sticky back. So that way you could just place a design on the shirt and it could come off after. So now I'm taking a sticker book with star stickers. You can use anything for this. I just chose this because the star shape was like a perfect size for the shirt. So I'm kind of just placing them on in like a pattern so that way it's easy to like organize. And then I'm going to take a light blue color, a dark blue color, red, and also I'm going to use a white color. So the reason why you want to use acrylic paints is because it stains and it won't wash off. So now I'm going to take an assorted amount of brushes, any brush that would work. And I'm going to be using this to paint it on the shirt. So I'm going to start with my red and just color in all the empty spaces. I remember when we broke up, the first Now I'm just going to take the blue and just fill in the whole star area. And it's okay to cover the stars because then you'll be taking them off. After your paint is dried a little, you could just peel off the stickers. And I'm using my X-Acto knife just to help me peel it off so it doesn't like smudge or anything. And yeah, so those are the stars and it's just really easy to do. And then now, since you're done, you just peel off the whole paper and it makes a really clean, perfect design. So thank you guys so much for watching and I hope you have a very happy and fun 4th of July. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!